Well, speaking of other news here, we have a liberal going viral for attending Trump rallies. There is a clip here of this young man doing yeoman's work. And I think it's a great thing to really show that we're not as divided as much as we think that we are. Because let's be frank, folks, the media does push a division in this country, as do I. I think we are divided on a lot of issues, but I do agree that us Americans, we do agree a lot more than what we really do think. Whether that's anything outside of politics, if you really think about it, whether it's sports or it's food or it's family or it's holidays, whatever it may be. I mean, we really do agree on a lot of things. We just don't focus on those things, especially here on the Bolt Brad Show. We're a political commentary show, folks. We're not going to zoom in on all those things. We got to zoom in what makes a difference. Well, a self-described liberal named Samuel Doerner on Tuesday told Fox and Friends he attended a recent rally for former President Donald Trump to see if he could make friends and establish a common ground. Like I said, there's a clip here from Fox News. Let's go ahead and watch it together.
Welcome back. Our next guest is a liberal who is going viral for reaching across the aisle to make new friends at a Trump rally.
I'm a liberal, and I went to a Trump rally to see if there was common ground. Going in, I was expecting aggression, but I actually experienced a lot of kindness.
Do you want to be friends?
Of course. Loved everybody.
Sure. I'm going to get a hug.
Sure.
Yeah. Yes!
That last clip was Holly, and she invited me to a woman's Bible study, so Malika and I went.
This is Samuel. One of Holly's
Hello.
Friends.
And again, we experienced incredible kindness.
They're a fun group of people. I'm a liberal,
and I went... TikTok user, 100 new friends, a.k.a. Samuel Doerner, joins us right now from L.A. Samuel, good morning to you.
Good morning. How you doing?
I'm doing okay. Great to meet you. We saw this. We thought we got to talk to this guy. So the idea was you wanted to go to what you, as a liberal, thought would be a hostile environment, a Trump event, and have that turn out.
It actually was much more friendly than I was expecting. As growing up in L.A., you think that these events are going to be like very aggressive. And also, I was kind of just saying that I was a liberal, but I was absolutely baffled that people wanted to talk and would actually be friends with me when I asked, want to be friends? And they said yes.
That's right. So ultimately, I think what you found.
But remember, we're a threat to the country, you guys. You're a threat, you little fascist, to democracy here. You're all MAGA Republicans. You're all Republicans. You're a threat to everybody. It just shows you the damage that some media outlets have done, CNN, MSNBC, and others, that if you as a Trump supporter wore a red hat, you'd be labeled racist. You'd get the shit kicked out of you on the streets. So if you went to Antifa, if you went to a Black Lives Matter protest, if you went to just any sort of protest that was on the other aisle wearing a MAGA hat, how do you think you'd be treated? Do you think you'd be welcomed with open arms like this man did when he said, hey, I'm liberal, out front to these people, and they welcome him? They invite him to Bible studies. That old cliche, why don't you come in and have dinner with us? We would love to have you, even though you're on the other end of the aisle. We're all Americans at the end of the day. I love this.
Is that it is easy to find common ground with people you do not agree with politically, right?
Yeah, I think that's what 100 New Friends and Jubilee is about. That's the company I'm working with. Is we're just trying to find common ground between humans. And I think at the end of the day, humans have a lot more common ground than we're led to believe. So.
Right. Let's take a look. Here's another clip. You trying to find common ground with more humans.
I'm a liberal, and I'm trying to make friends at a Trump rally to see if there's more common ground than I thought.
You want to be friends?
Oh, absolutely.
I'm Sam. What's your name?
I'm Todd.
Can you tell me about your shirt?
We're non-binary.
What does that mean?
Well, that means that we are very much against what our current socialist president is doing. We have a tremendous racial problem. We don't have to be part of that. We're not a part of that. We support people of all races, and so anybody that says that Republicans are racist are absolutely incorrect.
So, Samuel, after you made these videos, have you told your friends, hey, you know, I went to this Trump rally and people were friendly, and what has their reaction been?
I mean, some, like a lot of, well, when I was going over, they're like, you're going to Memphis, one of the homicide capitals of the world and of the country. And there's a lot of gun violence over there. And then you're going to a Trump rally on top of that. It seemed fairly scary. And I think that's honestly what I wanted to test. Can I go into what I thought was the most hostile environment I could? But when I went, I told them it was actually fairly friendly. And I think again, like, it's just about starting those conversations.
Right.
If you can start those conversations, you can actually understand where that common ground is, where it starts, and maybe where it ends. And even where it right. ends, you can discuss with each other, like,
right.
hey, like, let's find that common ground.
But you've got to start the conversation, and that's what you did by going there. I think going in, Samuel, you probably thought, you know what, I'm going to ask 100 people. I'll probably get 2 people who said, yeah, I want to be your friend. 49 out of 100 said, yeah, Samuel, I'll be your friend.
Yeah, I was so nervous going in. Like, I had a pit in my stomach the whole time. And the Trump rally was the last day I was there. And I was just kind of talking to people around yep. Memphis before that. And so, like, before the Trump rally, I'm like, okay, no one's going to want to talk to me. And there were a couple people who did not want to talk to me. But overall, everyone was super friendly. And then Holly, in that first video yeah. that you showed, she invited me to her women's Bible study class, like, out of the blue. She was so nice. And then me and my friend Malik went there. And again, like, just like, yep. a ton of empathy.
No kid. Samuel Donner, thank you for...
I think we need more of this in America, of having these viral, whether they're YouTubers or TikTokers, going out and just showing that we're not as divided as it's portrayed to be. I think in the political sphere, yes, but like I've said, the media, the progressive left, have really done a doozy in making Trump supporters and Republicans out to be racist, sexist, bigots, homophobes, all these crazy things, when in actuality, we're just patriots. We just want the best for everybody. We want what's best for this country. We don't think socialism, we don't think paying off student loans, we don't think affordable or affirmative action is the way to go. You know, all these things that Democrats want to push, we don't think that's the right direction for our country, and that's where we divide, that's where we split. And also, it's not okay just yelling out, oh, you're a racist, bigot, sexist, homophobe. So I love that this man, this young man, is spotlighting the gratitude, the humbleness, the loving that Trump supporters and Republicans are, because we carry and conserve the ideas that were passed down from our founding fathers. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness is what we inherit, and we need to pass that down to other people. We all have the right to pursue our liberties and our happiness here in America, and us sharing those values with one another, even those on the other side of the aisle, by inviting them to Bible study, is a good step forward for our country. I hope you enjoyed that clip from The Bald Brad Show. If you did, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all our future content.